it's undoubtedly true that the future of work is always in the future, it's also undeniably true that the future of your work has never been closer. The rise of robots, machine intelligence, distributed ledgers, quantum physics, a world being eaten alive by software. All of these trends point to a new world which is shaping up quite differently from any world we've ever seen or worked in before. For almost the last 10 years, the Center for the Future of Work has been cataloging and commenting on these and a whole host of other extraordinary dynamics. But in these 10 years, we've never attempted to pull together all of our analysis and insight into one report, until now. From and To is just that, a state of the union for the future of work. It's everything you wanted to know about the future of your work, but were afraid to ask. Here's a look at some of the key trends in the report. From hierarchies to wirearchies. From caste systems to feudalism to royalty and politics, and now in big multinational businesses, humans have always tended to organize themselves into hierarchies. But now, in our hyper-connected world, hierarchies are a bug, not a feature. A disconnect in a networked world. Now, millennials prefer to work in wirearchies, dynamic networks of connected nodes, free of predefined priorities or ranks. In many businesses, the agenda of the formal hierarchy is misaligned and often conflicts with the realities of how modern work gets done. Will hierarchies go entirely extinct? Probably not. But the future is a mix of both, of the formal and the informal, of the hierarchy and the wirearchy. From bits to qubits. Though modern digital technology can often seem miraculous, what's really miraculous is that it's all made possible by the simplest of concepts, ones and zeros. Individual transistors at the heart of computers are no more than on-off switches, represented as either one or zero. But now we're reaching the limit of bits, as CPU manufacturers struggle to make binary-based computing any smaller or faster. Enter quantum computing, long a scientific theory but now becoming a reality. These computers go beyond bits or binary by using quantum bits or qubits. Simply put, a bit can only be either one or zero. A qubit can be both one and zero at exactly the same time. With this step function in computational power, a whole new class of processing power is being revealed. Predicting traffic 45 minutes in advance, completely solving prime numbers, or modeling the molecular interaction of drugs with almost 100% accuracy. These are some of the scenarios that binary computers will never be able to achieve, but which will be in reach with quantum computing to hand. From the suit to the hoodie. The office and the suit have gone together like Laurel and Hardy since, well, Laurel and Hardy. Picture somebody sitting at a desk in an office in virtually any part of the modern world, and your mind's eye goes to a jacket on the back of a chair, a slightly loosened collar and tie, a yellow sticky note, don't forget the milk, placed on the edge of the computer screen. But now suits are for suits. Creative, mold-breaking leaders don't wrap themselves in the conformity of an idea or a drape. The suit no longer fits. Take a peek inside Goldman Sachs. Sure, you can still spot some suits, but the real power is off to the side of the room, invisible behind a 27-inch Mac, clad in a hoodie. 70 hours minimum a week of diving for pearls in pearl in a gray flannel suit does not compute. That a DJ now runs the world's most powerful financial institution is proof, if proof's needed, that every company is now a technology company and every company now dresses like one, or should. Hoodies, the $3,500 type from Loro Piana, not $19.99 from Target, rule. From retired to retired. For the last 100 years, the arc of a working life has been pretty clear. Go to school, go to college, get on a career ladder, knuckle down for 40 years, relax for a decade or so, and then die. But now retirement, a phase of life that used to last 10 or 15 years, from 65 to 80, stretches out ahead for 30 or 40 years. If we quit work at 65, have we saved enough money to last us that long? For many people, the answer is no. Live long enough to live forever, says Ray Kurzweil. Sure, but how am I going to be able to afford it? Fortunately, the rise of the gig economy offers us a potential lifeline. We never need to fully retire, or we can unretire as circumstances dictate. Gigs can put food on the table as long as we can keep in the game. Retired, we can seize the work opportunities that are blossoming across the gig economy. Ride-sharing services such as Uber and Lyft, platforms such as Upwork for writing, accounting, design, and related services, Guru for IT and engineering skills, Amazon's Mechanical Turk, offering knowledge workers a way to bid for expert work needed by organizations large and small. All of these offer the post-65 crowd a way to keep the money coming in rather than just going out. From mass-produced to me-produced, for the last 100 years, we've become accustomed, unless we're lord or lady of the manor, to wearing store-bought, off-the-shelf clothes. The result? Well, we all look kind of the same. Now, through rapid prototyping and short-run production with 3D printers, we're paving the way for an era of personalized, print-it-yourself products. Forget the same as what everybody else is wearing vibe. Now we want uber-personalized, one-of-a-kind, perfectly tailored clothing that's still affordable. Already, Nike has started using 3D printing for customized sports shoes. Adidas is getting into the SoBot game, a mixture of AI, robotics, and 3D printing. By taking a picture via an app, Adidas customers can have their body measurements taken and the data sent to the nearest SoBot, which will create the item of clothing to fit perfectly. No more ordering 3 versions of the same item to test the size and sending 2 back. Returns will diminish, as will the retail supply chain. The hope for a completely sustainable model of clothing and footwear production is fast becoming a reality. Shootopia is a product that, similar to the Adidas model, allows customers to take pictures via the app and have shoes custom made in a local digital fabrication center. The shoes are even biodegradable. The next step is to bring these production centers into our own homes with personal 3D printers. PIY is the eco-friendly future of manufacturing and retail. Ranging across technologies, business models, and demographics, From and To outlines what we consider the most important trends that will change what you do and how you do it, be you a chief executive, a student, a politician, or just a regular worker. Whether you're excited by the future or fearful, this is no time to not be paying attention. The future of your work is changing. This report is your field guide.